So, here we are again. Life is Strange Remastered. I've played the original on the Xbox, and it was just amazing. So, first time playing it remastered, so let's get straight into it. Episode 1, Chrysalis. Okay, here we go.
That was so surreal.
Hitchcock famously called film little pieces of time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay, I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow, from color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh, 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 shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me.
What?
Isn't that too easy? Too obvious? What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence? She had a brilliant eye, so she could have taken another approach.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Me too, Victoria. He captured the essence of post-war beat America, and there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era. But a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty without a beat. Which explains why Frank was Kerouac's photographic muse. And both were the great chroniclers of the 1950s. Well, we've all seen that iconic shot of Kerouac on the balcony. And if you haven't, shame, shame. Capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet.
Shut up.
Now, contrast Frank's stark Americana with Salvador Dali's surrealist photographs. Like Cocteau, he was a true Renaissance man. And his famous self-portraits are famous early examples of that truly awful word you pesky kids love so much. The selfie. And it's a great tradition.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Shut up. Let them happen.
and I wholeheartedly fight for your right to self-expression. Or selfie expression.
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here.
So if anybody wants to question the portrait as modern narcissism, they could go back hundreds of... Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
From the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius.
Sorry, Max. No more selfies right now.
In your textbook. Or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
It looks so good. Hi, Kate.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass. Hi, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Max.
You see the dilemma?
I know, Mr. Jefferson. I just worked so hard on the shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be concerned.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much. And
I
want to represent
Blackwell Academy. You have just. I hear that. Wanna go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
I like Kate.
I had my moment in the camera eye, and everybody should have that
chance. I only want to share whatever gifts I have with the world.
So good.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do we have to?
I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you. But life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Okay, let's go.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I feel like you have
you
welcome
always
to the real world.
Just cute.
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture during class.
What's the point of even coming?
Because Max wants everybody to see how cute she is.
I'm not paying her.
She plays it so shy.
I need a serious time out in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that because it's so fucking rough.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
Excuse me?
To all of you, American girls, it's sad to imagine a world without you. American girls, I'd like to be part of the world around you. Driving a car by the seaside, watching the world
empty.
From the bright
side. Nobody can see my meltdown, except for me.
That's my favorite song. I absolutely love that song. Tampon dispenser.
I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy,
anybody?
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
I did
now.
It.
Can you give
I
me
actually
an
did
of
it.
A photographer who perfectly captured
I'm a human
the human condition
time
in
machine.
Black and white. Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't
Diane
freak out.
Arbus.
Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces.
When I took my selfie, totally Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Kids call a selfie.
A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming this.
As you all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so I can go back in time. For
selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist.
The point can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me
he
after class.
Was a French painter,
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again
process
and give him the right answer?
Out fine detail in people's faces.
Okay.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just tripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
I
just really think
everyday heroes is an important cultural. I wish we didn't.
I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
I like Kate.
I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this process, but I also want everybody to... I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max... Don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. But I also want everybody to know that this photographic world is not for everybody. I had my moment in the camera eye, and everybody should have a chance.
I only want to share whatever gifts I have with the world.
I wish I could go talk to Mr. Jefferson about what's going on. But I can't.
Excuse me. Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Daniel.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class with those nerds.
that got to do with anything?
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing?
Don't
come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wowzer, it's happening again.
Ah, crap.
I'm so sick of people trying to control
me! I need a hammer to break it open.
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Rap.
Holy shit, I can't let this happen. No. If I can reverse time again, I can help her.
I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Oh.
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Before him.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around. In the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family. And one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it? After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later, in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
No. You see someone waving a gun? Report them.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her.
Do you want to meet for coffee after school? I need an excuse not to study, please. Make sure you check out Necromantic on my flash drive. Hey Mad Max, let's bust shit up. Cool.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
I'm actually in love with this.
Come on, Logan, bring it, bro. Yeah. Ow.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Oh. Hi, Max.
What are you reading?
Love today or die forever. Don't even say anything.
It's a bestseller. What to say?
Good point. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Oh. Hi, Victoria.
Oh, look. It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your wave hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
I really don't like Victoria. Now, if I'm right...
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Heh 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 heh.
Awesome.
Seeing as I have played this on the Xbox, I have a vague idea as to what to do.
Yeah.
So, oh yeah, he goes up the ladder.
No.
Aha.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Yes, because Victoria is definitely not going to see you tampering with something.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Hey, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo.
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Exactly.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Do I make fun of, or do I come for her? Make fun of.
Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. And no filter needed before I post this. Now, please move. I've had a messed up day, and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that.
Then again, two wrongs don't make a right.
Hurry, Courtney!
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long. How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say.
Let's draw.
Home sweet home, my favorite cocoon. It feels so nice to just relax. This day has been so damn bizarre, and it feels like it has gone on forever. Maybe I'll just wake up now and find out I was dreaming all of this. Or like Poe said, a dream within a dream.
Okay, let's get that fucking flash drive. Happy birthday, Maxine. We can't believe it's been 18 whole years since you were brought to us. Max, your principal sent me a message saying that you told some tall tales about a Blackwell honor student. Is this true? Yes. The principal said that this is a serious false charge and that he is worried you're telling stories. Call me ASAP so we can talk about this, Mom. Well then.
I look so pathetic. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties.
Oh.
Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here.
They could have, you know, made the cursor black or something. So you can actually see it. Oops. No.
I look so pathetic. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up.
Where is that flash drive?
Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note.
No.
Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
Okay. If I remember what
you
Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Never mind. We now know where Dana's room is.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Hey, out, Juliet. This is so stupid.
Answer, you wuss.
Now, where's Kate's room?
You are ridiculous.
Yes, yes, we will get to you in a minute. Where's Kate's room? Okay, sure. No.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Mason.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield. By the way, Juliet Watson.
Oops.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
If you don't let me out, I will see you.
How do you know?
Victoria Chase. You know her.
You could say that. But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But then Victoria did. I know the
proof of it. Oh, here we go.
That's real nice, Victoria. And who the hell thinks I'm a hipster? Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Okay. Print email. There we go.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Let's get out of here. Don't worry, Juliet. Don't worry.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Yay!
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Victoria is not nice. I don't get it. She has everything. And to pull that prank on a friend?
Just because they're in the Vortex Club doesn't mean they're BFFs. I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Okay. My camera will be ready shortly. See you shortly. I hope so. I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. The more it takes, the longer I take on my way. Just bye. Bye. Okay.
Ah, crap. Shit.
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
This action will have consequences.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Intervene.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday...
Oops.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Hi, Warren.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
No worries, Warren. I took a sweet shot of Victoria I can't wait to share.
Oh, score one for Team Max. It would be so karmic to see your ass clown face all over the interwebs.
I guess she does deserve it for all the shitty things she's done to people here.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
No, I've been way too busy with class and life.
Damn, girl, you had it like a year.
Or a week. I did browse through all the titles, drama queen.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Mm-hmm.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right?
Uh-oh.
You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now. Answer me, bitch!
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Ow!
Hey, leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
Wait,
in the bathroom!
No. Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren.
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody messes with me! Nobody!
Oh, he looks so good!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Bullshit. You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Broken. Man, are you cereal?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Got that weed, 420.
It won't play without any power.
Power strip.
Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play. Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Oops. Maybe in this box? Aha!
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Sure.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Okay. Blech. Hey Max, you around? Always, you okay? Did you want to get to you later today? Absolutely. I'll be free after 4. Talk to you later. Thanks again, Max, for helping me.
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. I should be able to find the tools I need here.
Trophy. Nope. Tools.
Ooh, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Okay, cardboard, push. No, push. Turn on. There we go.
Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
That's a good point.
Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
No. Close. Hi, Chloe.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Booyah, you skank. Karma's a bitch. Nice framing, too.
Wait. I've seen this before.
No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Yes.
Absolutely. Nathan Prescott had a fucking gun on you.
Gutless prick. That was scary. Who did you tell?
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes! Break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off! Turn it off!
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on! Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on?
Uh-oh.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now.
Uh-oh.
Please.
1 second.
There we go.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order. Whose is it?
Step in.
I'm sorry, that was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home, especially dopers.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
you? Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy. I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, put that thing down!
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Yes.
Isn't this awesome, Sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, Slowpoke!
Hold on. I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
I owe you, thanks for the day. I'll call you back. I'll call back later, okay? Swear. No problem. And you still have me to tell you a big secret. Kek. I don't even know what kek means.
Birds are so lucky, they can always escape. Chloe's step douche better not cause me trouble. Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
You're in a good mood.
Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
What files?
David stashes his secret X files in there. I saw them once, but he secures them now.
He kind of creeps me out. I bet the truth is out there in his files.
Most likely, but it's good you didn't find his files. He would go ballistic. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it. He's so hella fucking paranoid. I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
What's Nathan's secret?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Oh no! Not again! Why is this happening to me? Why am I here again?
Oops. Ah, crap. There we go. Okay.
October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away. Oh no. The tornado is headed straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years, which is so.
No, no, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But hi, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
That one line gives me chills. And there we go. So 58 reported Nathan, of course. Oh, okay. You intervened to help. Okay, 90%. You came out of hiding to intervene. Yeah. You didn't let Daniel draw your portrait. 38. You didn't sign Miss Grant's petition, 42. Oh. Okay. Oh. Yeah, I should have erased that. You watered your plant, 78. You didn't touch Stana's pregnancy test, of course. You didn't touch Victoria's photos, 72. You didn't write on a dirty RV. Oh. Oh. Save the bird, you let the bird die. Oh. Wait, what was the bird? You didn't break Chloe's snow globe. 97%. Episodes. Let's go back. Well, we shall leave it there. I'm in love with the remastered. I absolutely love it. And we'll pick off in Out of Time, episode 2. So until then, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.